In this video, I'm going to walk you through a brand new AI app that I built using Bubble, which is a no-code tool. Everything that you see here was built without code, using Bubble and connecting to AI APIs. In this case, I used Anthropic's Claude API because I feel like it worked really well for this use case compared to OpenAI's GPT-4 API. And in the video, I'm going to walk through what are the features that I built and how did I build them, talk through the steps that I took. And hopefully by the end of the video, you'll be inspired to build your own AI application. I actually built this app to use for Nocode MBA itself. So this was a process that before we were doing manually, and I wanted to see if I could build an app that could automate the process that we were already doing. And I found it really useful for myself, so I decided to productize it and turn it into an app that others could use as well. This video is brought to you by Nocode MBA. If you want to learn how to build your own AI applications just like this, check out our Building Apps with AI course, which I have a link for in the description, where you'll learn how to build your own AI applications using Bubble and AI APIs like OpenAI, Stable Diffusion, and more. So here we are on the homepage of BlogFox. And the way that I built it is that anyone can try it out for free. And there's some more information here about the actual app if you scroll down on the homepage. But what I'm going to do is enter in a URL, and we're actually going to see how this app works live. So I entered in one of Nocode MBA's most recent YouTube videos. I'm going to go ahead and click try it for free. And here we go. We're on the page where we're generating the video. So I can talk through some of the kind of workflow that I built here for this app. So the first thing that happens is we transcribe the video, we get the transcription from YouTube, and then using that transcription, we're creating an SEO keyword optimized outline. So we're getting SEO keywords and then creating an outline that uses those keywords and includes it. When we write the blog, we're also incorporating those SEO keywords throughout the blog post so that it is optimized for SEO right off the bat. And we're using Anthropic's Claude Opus model, which is Anthropic's most expensive and most powerful model. So it does make it take a little bit longer to actually generate, but you know, typically you're not going to be watching your blog generate. You're just going to hit generate, and then it'll let you know when it is ready. And then some of the additional features that we've built in to the app is the ability to add writing samples to help the final blog post result match your existing tone, add custom instructions. We can add relevant links based on existing links that you might have on your existing blog. And we're also generating images unique for each blog post. So I did a lot of testing and prompt engineering to try and make it so the result of the blog post is really high quality. In my opinion, I think that the results are much higher quality than something from just ChatGPT or even using very similar workflows, but with OpenAI's GPT-4 models. I found Anthropic's Claude model to just be a little bit better at writing more like a human, so it doesn't sound like it is written by an AI. And then the video itself is embedded here into the actual blog post. So we have this all set up, and then we have a way here to save our blog and create a user and then go to the dashboard. So I'm gonna do that real quick. So I just created an account, and now I can continue to the dashboard here, and then we'll just finalize the profile. So I built a feature into the app where it's checking, and if you don't have this information about yourself, then it's going to ask you for your name and to name your team, which by default is just your first name's team, but you can change that as well. There's also a trigger for each user where if they have not clicked this button, which essentially it means that they've read this onboarding post, then it will pop up with this onboarding post to tell the user a little bit more about the app. So if they click got it, then that will check it off and it will never show that again. And I'm checking on page load in Bubble of how to do this. And then here on the left side, something I do want to call out is I used the design framework Basis, B-A-S-I-S, which is a really helpful design framework for Bubble, which allows you to copy elements and paste them into your app. And it makes it a little bit quicker to build an app that looks good right away. which is helpful. And you know, I made tweaks to it, but it's still helpful to have. So I'll walk through some of the features that I built into this app. So we have first just a generate tab where you can generate a video either by a default URL. So just enter in a URL, or if you upgrade your account, you have the ability to connect a YouTube channel. Then when you connect your YouTube channel, you can just press a button, view all of the videos in your account, and just press generate. You also can watch for new videos to be created to automatically generate new blog posts. So to do that, I've used backend workflows in Bubble to basically, on a schedule, check every, I believe in my case, I did 12 hours right now, but you could do it to check more often, to just check all of the YouTube channels in the database and see if there are new videos. And I've used an API to connect to YouTube to get all of the channel information based on a channel ID. So YouTube has open APIs that allow people to access that data. Within the articles itself, you can go in and actually edit those articles, and then there's a way to see the word count. You can regenerate the image, change the slug, which is helpful if you are syncing to a blog. So if you have your Webflow API information in, you can just sync it directly to Webflow, and that will include the slug there, which is really helpful. And I'm building a WordPress plugin as well soon, or which integration, which is going to allow people who have WordPress blogs to also automatically send the posts on. And then here in the editor, you can make changes directly in. You can add links, anything that you need to do to just make changes directly here to the blog post. You also could just, you know, copy everything and paste it into Webflow, WordPress, or any other blog CMS that you have. And then you can change it from draft to published. You can also edit the presets that you have. I'll go back in a second and show you how those presets work. So here under presets, you can change and add additional instructions. So the default custom instructions just says to use occasional bullet points to highlight key information and make the post easier to skim. So you can take that away. You can add in additional custom information, change the tone, output language, etc. So there's a lot that you can change there. And then what's really powerful is adding writing samples. So this is what I've done, is give people the ability to add writing samples. I add it to the prompt when we're generating the blog post and tell the AI to use them as examples of style and tone, but not content. And that is something that I found really helpful to improve and kind of customize the quality of the blog posts. Next is links, which you can't see right now because I'm on a free account, but with links, you can upload as many links as you want. So you can upload, you know, 300 links from your own blog post, and then the app will automatically place links into your blog post, which are relevant, which is really helpful for SEO and something that saves a lot of time. There's a few other things like updating your team or inviting users to your team. And then there's an account feature as well. There's a feature that is coming soon, which is programmatic, which is going to allow you to upload, let's say, 200 blog post titles and then generate blog posts based on those titles as opposed to based on a YouTube video. So it's going to allow you to programmatically create content for your blog that is not related to a YouTube video, but will help you scale your SEO. So it's a new feature that will be coming soon. So I hope that this showed you what is possible building in Bubble and kind of how complex the apps can get building in Bubble. And this is only scratching the surface. There's a lot more that you could build into this app to make it even more powerful. But hopefully this was helpful for you. And again, if you want to learn how to build your own AI applications, check out the link in the description and go to our Building Apps with AI course where you'll learn how to build apps very similar to this. If you have any questions at all, just leave a comment below and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get all of our future content for free. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.